This stuff's poison. I'm in trouble.
I'm in.
I gotta change up my whole routine.
For reals.
Hey, Jim Schultz here for F Cubed. And as long as you don't have coconut oil all over your fingers right now, go ahead and tap that subscribe button and make sure you stay tuned to the end, because if fat loss is your goal, I got a little something for you. But Karin, say it ain't so. I mean, coconut oil, pure poison? That's a bit much, don't you think? I mean, we can debate coconut oil health risks. Is coconut oil really healthy or not? All day long. But coconut oil and superfood have long been joined at the hip, united in holy matrimony. So what is the truth? Well, allow me to offer up my thoughts, having spent nearly 20 years trying to optimize my own nutrition for the competitive bodybuilding stage. First and foremost, I am not a doctor. Well, technically, I am a doctor. But I'm not that kind of doctor. So take whatever I'm gonna say with a grain of salt, or maybe a tablespoon of coconut oil. That being said, we are not gonna get super detailed into the science because I don't understand it. If you guys want a real detailed, thorough analysis of all this, go to examine.com. Man, if you have any supplement or nutrition questions that you wanna see independently researched, examine.com. They've got coconut oil health risks and a whole bunch more. So what I think this all really boils down to is saturated fat. And first and foremost, let's get it out there. Is coconut oil saturated fat or unsaturated fat? Well, it's saturated fat. So next question, is saturated fat healthy? Well, this is where things kind of start to get a little more interesting. And I think this is the main point of contention between coconut oil and Karin Michels. Now, saturated fat is either medium chain triglyceride or long chain triglyceride. I said we weren't gonna dig into the science too deeply, but here's a little bit. Coconut oil is 65% medium chain triglyceride. So it is a great source of MCT fats. Now, some evidence has shown that medium chain triglycerides can lead to a faster metabolism. So it appears that your body actually processes MCTs and LCTs differently. And that's pretty interesting, but it actually is about to get a whole lot more interesting when we look at cholesterol here in just a couple of minutes. Still, leaving, you know, MCTs and LCTs out of it for a second, I mean, more saturated fat has been shown to raise the lipid concentration in your blood, thus increasing, you know, that LDL bad cholesterol. I mean, this is what gets all the headlines, and I think this is really what that Harvard professor was bashing coconut oil about. But again, this does not take into account the long chain triglyceride or the medium chain triglyceride issue. It also doesn't account for particle size, which now many doctors believe that when it comes to your cholesterol, it's actually more important the particle size. If you have small, dense particles, those appear to be a lot more problematic than the large, fluffy ones. Those large fluffy particles appear to even be protective in some nature. So there you go, man. When it comes to coconut oil health risks, maybe you've been doing coconut oil for brain health. Maybe you've been doing coconut oil for heart health. Maybe you put MCT oil in your coffee. Maybe you put coconut oil in your coffee. I don't think you need to stop doing any of that because of one random poison reference. Besides, man, just like everything else in fitness, I mean, this is just one piece to the puzzle. And if you've got your eye on your macros, then there is no way that you have enough fat grams to put down enough tablespoons of coconut oil to do any serious damage. But hey, man, coconut oil or not, if fat loss is your goal, then I've got three tips for you here today. Nutrition, weight training, cardio, totally free. Link down in the description. I do these every single day, and I actually can't imagine not doing them. All right, so let's wrap it up, man. Quick Q&A. Question number one. When it comes to particle size, do you want dense or fluffy? Fluffy. Finally, man. In the world of fitness, fluffy finally wins. Question number two, do I think coconut oil is poison? No. But even if I did, man, I'm not gonna judge you. That might be just what you need. How do I know? You might be the Count of Monte Cristo. I'm not in the business of profiling my audience. And lastly, most importantly, question number three, did I actually put coconut oil in my hair? Yes. And that was the first and last time that's gonna happen. So as always, man, hit me with that like, hit me with that share, hit me with that subscribe. We'll see you guys next time.